Let's go ride bikes. Right now, I'm on my way to this town called Perk. It's just right outside of Weiden here in Germany. I'm gonna be doing a 165-kilometer bike ride, sportive. So it's 103 miles. It's gonna be 7,200 feet of climbing, or 2,450 meters, roughly. Yeah, and I'm running late. Story of my life, but can't wait. I headed up to registration. Got the old trusty steed out, and a lot of people walked over here. Look at that. Why walk when you can ride? All right, look, man. I know this is supposed to be like that, but taking away my aero gains, dude. Like, this isn't a BMX race. I don't know why these sportifs like to have it to where you have your number out there, but man, I'm riding 100 miles. I need all the aero gains I can get, okay? No such thing as too much shaving cream. Sandwich. Nutella. I'm gonna want some real food while I'm out, so. Might have too much, but I guess that's better than not having enough. Glasses. I don't know which lenses I wanna use today. No, put spit on your lenses. Keep them from fogging up. These are not real POC sunglasses. I found these on Amazon. Over the straps. All right, see y'all later.
Let's see if I can find a place to piss.
Ja, wie so im Marathon, die Tempoläufer haben die quasi Tempofahrer.
Alright, so we're about to get started. Turn on the Wahoo, power meter, heart rate monitor, all that stuff. Pair the phone, power meter's hooked up, and heart rate monitor's set up, so choose my route now. The course is gonna be well marked, but I just want to see how much longer I have to suffer. So I already have it saved from my commute. And if it's not, I'm gonna be upset because I did. Go to maps, go to route. I'll figure it out on the ride. Okay, first rest stop. It's crazy over here. We're at mile 20. Feeling good. Had a nice group. Now I gotta get them to stamp my thing. Okay, so we're 20 miles in, 1,800 feet of climbing in so far, 83 miles to go. Yep. Okay, we're about halfway up this climb, and going turtle speed. That's okay. Maintaining about 230, 250 watts. Sucks going slow like that because my glasses fog up. But cool place. All right, so the biggest climb's done. We're at the our highest elevation that we're gonna be at for this whole thing. Cool thing is, I've already climbed almost 3,000 feet, and we're only 24 miles in. So made a sandwich real quick, and then we're gonna continue on. All right, so we made it to Czech. Yeah. So this gentleman's saying that 30 years ago this border was, it was, what'd you call it?
It's an iron wall.
Iron wall. He said nobody could, that was an iron wall. No crossing, but now we're riding bikes across it. So, fun stuff. We're 32 miles in. Just finished our second real big climb, and we're at 3,600 feet of elevation gain. So, almost done. Right. Okay, we made it to rest stop number two. We're 41 miles in, and we have done 4,000 feet of climbing. So we're most of the way done with climbing. Thank God. All right, so rest stop and check is done at the waters. And we are, let's see if I can do this. I think we're somewhere around there. So we got five more climbs. Do it. So far I'm feeling pretty good. Don't have a, not really cramping or anything like that too bad. Really trying to limit my time at the rest stops because, yeah, it's not good. Back on the road.
Yeah.
All right, made it back into Deutschland. We're at 6,000 feet of elevation climbed so far. 65 miles in. So, there it is. Back in Deutschland. The lady told me to look at this stuff. So, I don't know what it is. Kind of cool. Right. Only 35 miles to go. And I feel fantastical. That lady was really nice. Because at first, she's probably getting the bike lane, huh? At first I thought she was like waving towards the German border, and I thought she was telling me like, get out of Czech, get out. No, it turns out she was just trying to tell me where all the other riders are going. So thank you for that, that was cool. But yeah, it's funny because I only have 1200 feet of climbing left, well 1100 now. And I've been riding here so long, I just considered that flat. I was like, oh, thank God. It's basically flat now. So, I'm at 4 hours and 23 minutes in. I'm making much better time I mean, making a much better time than I thought I was gonna. Third rest stop. We got a hot chow. This man's pouring beer for everybody. Whiskey?
Yes.
Yeah? So they got whiskey. Hello.
Letztes Mal war es so kalt und so gedrängt hat es letztes Jahr.
Boom. Thank you.
Bitte schön.
I'm at the last rest stop. Don't have time to jack around. I'm trying to get home. So. Finally, over the last hill. So, I didn't call that a climb at first, but shit. That's a fucking climb. Didn't look like much on the map. I feel like I've had a headwind this whole freaking ride. Okay, so we're finally done. Grand total. Let's see. So 102 and a half miles, 6 hours, 39 minutes, 45 seconds. Average power 159. Average normalized power 199. TSS of 390. 3,273 kilojoules. Yeah, cool. I need to call my wife. Hey babe.
Disappointed.
Hey, I finished. I love you. Bye. Guess the line's over here.
Ein Bier bitte.
Ein helles?
Ja, helles.
Ja. Ein helles. 2,50.
Oh, it's so nice. I gotta get me a bratwurst. He's winning Germany. I burn the calories. I deserve it. Steak, some?
Yeah. One?
Yeah.
3,50.
Thank you, sir. Look, man. Life's short. Get the steak. That's what I always say. Time to eat this. Go back to the car. Get some protein. And drive home. What sucks about this is you got a 30 minute drive home and I drive a freaking standard. So my legs are toast. But actually, you know, they're not that bad. So this testament's to having a power meter and knowing how to use it, because honestly, I've ridden my whole life without a power, or without power, without a power meter. And I just started using a power meter this past year, and what a freaking difference it's made. Last time I did this ride, I did the 75 miler, and I was done, dead. And I did it in just about the same time that I did today's ride in, but I did 102 miles. And it just has to do with pacing, especially with something that's this, with this much undulating terrain. There's a lot of hills here, so having that power meter really helps. I think the next thing that'll help a lot is when I get rid of this standard gearing. I felt like a real hard man of the sport because I got standard cranks or a standard chainring on there. I got 5339 in the front and 1125 in the back.